What is the journey? If spirit is true, if God is here, then what is the journey? Now, yes. It must be some sort of a stubborn refusal to accept what is here now. Must be some sort of a idea of how something should be, and therefore we create this idea of a journey. Is that it? Because the journey implies there is a destination, isn't it? If you are already that, if you are here now, and if you are independent of the content of our thinking, because once we see that these thoughts are not for me, they're not even about me in reality. They're about some projection. It can never truly come to life. If we see this, that the thoughts are about a projection which can never truly come to life, then that is the dropping of this idea. No? The dropping of these ideas is the end of the journey. Is the end of conditioning. We were discussing maybe after satsang yesterday that to pick up one thought is like picking up the entire tree of conditioning, one leaf. Because in this moment right now, if you don't refer to any thoughts about ourselves, then where is the conditioning? There could be some energetic conditioning which remains, but that's okay. Even that is not suffering unless we believe a thought about it. So see how when we pick up one presumption about our separate existence as an individual entity, then we pick up the entire basket of ideas, the entire basket of conditioning. And without thoughts, there is no journey also. But we have to be a little bit things because it can also be taken just mentally and say, I can just drop the search. What is the need for satsang then? You see? But if it is just conceptual in that way, it is not truly the end of suffering. Okay, so one thing very important for us to understand is that openness and resistance are opposites and cannot really coexist. Although we can say, let's be open even to our resistance, it's okay at some point to say this. But actually, they are opposites. The fist is either closed or it's open. You see, it's either resisting or it's open. You see, but this openness is the end of suffering. Openness cannot suffer. In openness, you cannot suffer. Whatever idea you might even have about yourself. So, that is a true indicator. The end of suffering, not the end of pain, but the end of suffering, mostly, is the true indicator for the dropping of the search. In fact, the dropping doesn't feel like I dropped something also after that. Many times in Advaita, we just meet people who come to this, you know, very strong idea. Oh, I am dropping the search. I am dropping. The I is still the wrong one in that. Yeah. Is it become a little confusing? Should I start again? Oh, it's okay. So basically what I'm saying is that all conditioning, the idea of journey included, is not needed if right now we are not going with the content of our thoughts, if you're not buying anything that the mind is selling, you see? Including thoughts about the end of the journey, the end of the search. And how do I know? So if the idea of suffering comes, it is based on this idea of individual entity and the idea of the ego. And we said that openness and ego cannot coexist, because ego is another name for resistance, the non-acceptance of what is. So this realization that what I am is it already is the end of the journey. But this realization also comes with the understanding that I am not dependent on the content of my thoughts. Many times we have these ideas that yes, now I realize what I am, therefore I should be now free to engage with my thoughts as much as I like. And this one usually is asking for trouble. Why would you want it? Once you discover who you are, who is the lawyer who is still defending thoughts? And saying, but I am also consciousness. I am also consciousness. Yeah. So as we allow ourselves to be open, non-resistive, even to thoughts, in fact, to give them our belief is to resist. I can find no other way to resist except to give belief to our thoughts. Is there any other way? And we can look together, because this is the first time I feel this is escaping my mouth. So I haven't deeply contemplated. We can look.